Hey, what's up YouTube? Welcome back to the channel. It's Christine with Gage Girl Training, an online meal planning and coaching service. I'm a food scientist and chemical engineer, and in today's video, I am going to share how I naturally reset my hormones. So let's get started. So as you guys know, I've been talking about hormone health a whole lot on this channel lately, and this is actually a topic that is very near and dear to my heart, and I'm gonna go a little personal in this video and share my experiences with why I decided that I needed a hormonal detox. So when your hormones are imbalanced, it's not always the extremes that you would think. It's not always irregular periods. It's not always infertility. It's not always growing chin hair, all those types of things, even though those things are examples of hormone imbalances. I am 39. I'm going to turn 40 January 8th. And I have noticed ever since I climbed north of 35 years old, I noticed that I would struggle more with my fat loss, meaning I couldn't just do the things I did in my 20s. I couldn't do the things I did in my early 30s. And for me to get to certain levels of body fat, it always felt like I needed just so much more effort, as if there was like so much less margin for error, where if I would ever have a period where I would be off track, so to speak, I couldn't bounce back as readily. And with that, I started noticing body fat accumulating in my torso. Now, I'm a mesomorph, so for my body type, I can gain weight easily, I can lose it relatively easily, but I started noticing this cellulite and lower abdomen fat that I didn't have before. And even though I would look strong, even though I would look fit and healthy, for me, I know that my body was carrying more fat and just a certain level of thickness in my lower stomach that made me feel extremely uncomfortable in my own body. Now, in addition to that, I started noticing my body's sensitivity to carbohydrates was changing. Now, if you're not sure what your carb tolerance level is, I have a quiz here that you guys can check out, and I'll put the link below. Assess what your carb tolerance is. But I noticed, you guys know I like rice. I'm half Filipino, grew up eating rice as like the main course, and like anything, the meat or vegetables was always like the sides, but the rice was always the main course. I started noticing that about 6 to 12 months ago, I had this lunch and I got Singapore noodles from this Thai restaurant. And I remember feeling, not Thai, Malaysian. I remember feeling so groggy and tired after eating that. And yes, it was a high carb meal, but I never would feel like that level of crash. I've always been fine with carbs, but I've noticed that my body has been growing more and more sensitive to carbohydrates. And I still need carbs. I'm not gonna go on keto. I'm not gonna go on an extreme. But what I did was I created a reset. And in my 21-day reset protocol, there is a 7-day detox phase. And the 7-day detox phase, the whole purpose is to allow your body to naturally detox excess estrogens. And you do that by going higher in dietary fiber, by going lower in carbohydrates, by going higher in fat, and by making sure you're having a good moderate amount of protein with every meal. And I have to tell you guys, the main reason for me doing this, honestly, was to explore, you know, the benefit of my meal plan, to explore what the experience was going to be like for my clients. Because in my mind, I'm not menopausal. I am not dealing with any of those things. But I have to tell you guys, I was shocked at how my body changed. My mental clarity went through the roof. My energy levels went up, and it actually helped to lower my stress, if you could believe that. And I am a person who is naturally prone to brain fog, more from just a practical perspective because I always have so much going on. But I started noticing that my ability to concentrate was dwindling. I almost felt like I have ADD, where I just struggle to concentrate. I've noticed again this lower belly abdomen. Like I can get like my upper abdomen like nice and lean, but from like the navel down, like I would just feel like I had this like little uncomfortable amount of fat. And after the 7-day reset phase, and you guys will see what that looks like in my hormone reset plan, I was eating higher calories, closer to my TDEE level. I dialed back my exercise from 6 days a week to only 3. I had the most regular bowel movements I've ever had in my entire life. And not to be TMI, but the level of regularity just felt so cleansing to the body. I've noticed that protrusion in my lower abdomen dropped, and I don't have any food intolerances, you guys. I've noticed that my energy has been clearer and just, I didn't feel sleepy or bogged down after meals. And honestly, I just felt better. And I feel so good doing this that I can actually see myself doing this at least maybe once a month, maybe once every other month. And I cycle this into my regimen because what this did for my body and my mental clarity. And again, the biggest benefit that I really saw was I saw my lower abdomen go from like a little protruded and puffy to just flat, like flat. I'm so pleased to be able to offer this opportunity for you guys to experience the same. So you guys can check out my 21-day hormone reset program. And I'm specifically referring, there's a 7-day detox in there, and there's an additional 14 days where in the plan, I'll explain how the whole thing works. But I went higher in my cruciferous vegetables, went higher in my greens, higher in my fiber. And if you struggle to do these things naturally, you guys can check out my hormone reset bundle, which is now live on Gage Life. It consists of my prebiotic fiber, which is great to help the body naturally detox of excess estrogens and excess cholesterols. My hormone balancing supplement IC3 and Indole-3 carbinol, as well as my new vegan probiotic, which contains 16 strands and over 50 billion CFUs, colony forming units of good gut health promoting bacteria. So if you have been irregular and your body is just telling you that something's off, this detoxification of the liver has been such an eye-opening, body-changing, mind-changing, and it makes me honestly regret that I have never explored this before. I only wish I explored it sooner. And the reason why I have kind of stayed away from exploring detoxes is because detoxes have a tendency to be poorly designed crash diets. And this detox is anything but that. This detox is higher in calories, by no means starving. I was, you know, between a deficit of 500 and closer to my TDEE. So it's a very, very modest minor deficit for me. And what I found was my body was just loaded on nutrients that it needed to release just excess-ish inside of me. And I have never felt better. So you guys can learn more about it here. Check out the link below and ask me your questions in the comment section. What do you want to know about the experience? Have you ever tried a hormonal detox? Have you ever tried to reset your hormones? What benefits have you had? Now again, guys, remember, I don't have menopause. I don't have traditional signs of estrogen dominance, but I was just feeling like my body needed a reset, and it was because my liver function wasn't optimal, and I gotta tell you guys, I have not felt better. So check it out, guys. Let me know your questions, and I'll see you in the next one.